Hey guys, Devin here from American Aquarium during the morning sunrise of my home tank. Question of the day today is, what's the purpose of sunrise, sunset? And it's a really good question. That's actually something that's newer to the hobby because in fluorescent lighting, we didn't have a sunrise, sunset. Lights just clicked on with a timer. Now we have the technology where we can kind of ramp up lights, ramp down lights, and then even cooler technology now where we can have 365-day lunar cycles where your lights will match your region's time zone and ramp up and get high intensity in the middle of the day and ramp back down and even have a lunar cycle. So it's a good question. I think really we don't have a complete answer, but what we kind of do know is that plants and corals respond a little bit better to ramping up intensity, just like out in nature where they have to, in the morning, have less intense light and throughout the day have more intense light. And then also too, what has been shown is that certain corals will actually spawn because of the lunar cycle. So they will actually have some moonlight through the night and during the day. So the whole cycle is actually just bringing a healthier plant and coral, which actually leads to propagation of the plant and coral. So they're cool to look at, of course. And they also have a little science behind them of why they are important. They're not required lights that are just popping on, popping off. We've seen many tanks successful that, and plants and corals are, they're living creatures, so they're going to adapt to that, and no matter what kind of light cycle you have. The one thing I would recommend is don't always change your light cycle, because just like nature, they're not going to completely change. I mean, there's some variations, but it's not like one day and one the next day. The plants will adapt, of course, but best is to keep just a normal cycle and keep it long term. And then two, if you guys want to know some more about moonlighting, a lot of people think if they put a blue light over their aquarium, they're giving a moonlight. It's a nice effect, they can see it at night. Well, actually something is that moonlight is not blue, so you're actually giving a different color of lighting to your tank than actually what the moon is. It's a white light, so just a real less intense white light. And so that blue light actually can lead to algae issues over time. So just keep that in mind if you're looking for an aesthetic light at night. There is lots of new controllers and features. If you're gonna look at a light that has a built-in controller, I really urge you to take a look at the quality of the fixture before I'd rather put money in quality of fixture than have a nice feature like a 365-day lunar cycle. And then I would expect that feature to cost a little bit of money, because LEDs are meant to be ran at a certain intensity. So when you're adjusting those intensity and then actually having them like ramp up and stuff, that is something that the LEDs are not completely designed to do. So you'd really want to go with a higher technology that's something a little more quality built, so you're ensuring long-lasting life of the fixture. These things are rated for like 10 years, but if you get a cheaper fixture and it's got the 365-day cycle on it, I would bet that it would be way less of a lifespan. So that's kind of the lowdown on the morning ramp up, sunset. My personal tank has just got an hour in the morning, hour at night, and it's just nice to kind of see it come on gently and then kind of work up more intensely. So hope you appreciate it. I will talk to you next time. Bye.